Welcome to Domaine Canaris Virtual Happy Hour. This week we are going to be focusing on easy happy hour snacks. I think that's probably one of our other favorite subjects. I'm Erin Stauffer and I'm here with Phoebe Olberg.
Hello.
And we, did the cocktails. It could have been 10 years ago for all I know at this point. It feels the time is a blur at this point, but we thought it'd be fun to add some food elements in here, but we wanted to make it easy. It is happy hour, and we both love to snack, so, or at least I know. Snacking is great. So I'm going to start off on a snack, and we're going to do some varying ranges of easy. I think we all have our own interpretation of what is easy and what isn't, but I'm going to be starting off with some puff pastry straws, cheese straws, I'm sorry. So I'm going to start with puff pastry, and I prefer buttered puff pastry. You can use I'm not going to say the brand, you can use the regular brand that you get at the grocery store, but I think the butter puff pastry is much better, and I'm pretty sure that Trader Joe's actually has an all butter one, and this is the brand that I'm using right now, Dufour, I think I'm saying that right, and it's delicious. I happen to get this one at Whole Foods, but so I'm going to put, for this, I'm just going to take the piece of puff pastry, it's 14 ounces, and I'm actually going to flour the board. I probably should have done this before I put it down, but that's okay. I'm just going to flour the board so that it doesn't stick. And then I'm going to put a little flour on top of the puff pastry. And then I'm not going to really roll it out, right? Roll it in. I'm not going to roll it out to flatten it, although you could make it a little thinner if you wanted to. I'm just going to roll it to get some of the creases out. And you'll see it, you know, when it comes in a box, it's actually folded in multiple pieces. So I'm just going to give it a little flattening it out. And then I'm going to take egg wash. And this is one egg and one tablespoon of water. And then we have these recipes online. You're going to see that I said to be generous with the egg wash on here. Sometimes when you're making pastries, they'll just say to brush it lightly. I'm saying to be a little on the generous side because you're going to want to make sure that the cheese is going to stick to this. And you'll see that in the next side, so I'm gonna just make sure I put on a decent amount of the egg wash. You can see me doing that. The thing I love about these is they're very easy, and you can eat them warm out of the oven, and they go really well with all of our sparkling wines. I can't say that I have necessarily a favorite. I think that they pair beautifully. So we have egg wash. And then we're gonna put the cheese on. So this is a cup of Gruyere and a half a cup of Parmesan cheese. So I'm just gonna spread it out. Try to get it as evenly as you possibly can. It doesn't necessarily have to be perfect. We're gonna twist these up, so you're gonna get some little craggy bits of cheese here and there anyway. So I'm gonna just try to get it as even as possible. And then you can do this part with your hands, or you could do this actually with a rolling pin. I'm gonna do it with a rolling pin because I think that everybody wants to share these when we're done, so I don't wanna gross everybody out by getting my hands all over it. And it's less messy doing it this way. So, just gonna roll it. You're not really doing this to flatten it, you just wanna make sure that the cheese is sticking to the puff pastry. And this is where the egg wash comes into play because it's helping adhere. So then, I almost skipped the steps. So you can put any kind of herbs on here that you want to. Thyme would be really nice. You could do onion powder, garlic powder. I don't think I would do anything overly assertive. It'd probably ruin the sparkling wine experience a little bit. But you can do what you want. I'm gonna just do a little paprika. I love paprika. I actually use it in a lot of stuff. And I think it actually also adds a nice little color after these have baked too. And I'll show you the finished product. I did actually do those with paprika too. I'm freestyling it with paprika, but it's about a half a teaspoon you want to put on. And then I'm using a pizza cutter. You can use a You could use a knife if you want. I think the pizza cutter is a little easier. And I'm gonna do, you wanna do about a half inch to three quarter of an inch. It doesn't have to necessarily be perfect. And I'm gonna do long strips. I'm gonna pull this up just a little bit so you can see it. I'm doing it the long way here. You could do it the shorter way. I like the longer sticks. So I'm just gonna take one of these, I'm gonna pick it up, and you're gonna have a little cheese fly off, and that's totally fine. But you just wanna twist like this. Twist it, and then put it down. Voila, it's pretty easy. Just make sure that your puff pastry is cold. And if it's not, if it warms up in this whole entire process, just go ahead and put it in the freezer for a couple minutes and it'll warm right back up. So again, just twist and you're done. So then you're gonna put these in the oven at, let me see, I can't remember, 375 for 15 to 20 minutes. Just keep your eye on them. I would put on the timer for 15 minutes and then keep your eye on them. I had to do it for 20 minutes with my oven, but every oven is different, so I can't wait to eat them. So this is actually the finished product, and you can see this is what they start looking like. You can see all the cheese. Hopefully you can see all the brown bits on here. I would like to acknowledge, by the way, if you can't see the brown bits on here, if Evie and I are a little dark right now, we wanted to make sure that you could enjoy this wonderful view, so we're backlit a little bit more than we might normally be. That's okay.
That's fine with me.
Yeah, exactly. We skip in everything up right, so you can't see everything that's going on.
You always got a shower.
Yeah, exactly. So the next thing I'm going to show you is the smoked salmon dip. And this, again, is very, very easy. I am going to look at my instructions because I can't remember this one exactly off the top of my head. So this one starts off with 8 ounces of smoked salmon, and you're going to want to roughly chop that smoked salmon. And then you just take your food processor and you're going to put in 8 ounces of cream cheese, and then a quarter cup of sour cream, and so I didn't want to bring my big container of mayonnaise, so I brought a little container of mayonnaise or a little pack of mayonnaise, so another quarter cup of mayonnaise, and then 3 tablespoons of fresh dill. Again, you want to roughly chop that. You could do more dill than that if you want to. I think it overwhelms it a little bit, but once we blend it up, you can put more things in to taste. It's up to you at that point. And then a half a clove of garlic, and mince that before you put it in. 1 teaspoon of lemon zest, and then start with 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. Put it in the food processor with the salmon and blend it all up. Once you're done, you can put in salt and pepper. I would be cautious with the salt because some salmon is salty than others, so I would definitely taste it first. Salt, pepper, and then if you want more lemon juice, put in another half tablespoon to a tablespoon of lemon juice. It's really up to your preference. It's super easy. It goes wonderfully with our rosé. And I like to point out, last week, TJ Evans and Zach Miller talked about our still rosé, which was a new release for us, and I'd like to point out that it's almost gone, but it goes with both our sparkling and our still rosé beautifully, and you can see it's got this pretty pink color. If you want a chunkier dip with the salmon side, you could blend everything up without the salmon, and then finely chop the salmon and hand mix it in, but you're not going to get this pretty pink, sandy color. So I would just You can try it, and if you prefer it to be blended, you can just put it back in the food processor and blend it up. I actually tried this with a couple things, and I think baguette would be really good with it, crostini, but I particularly like these. This isn't necessarily Ritz cracker, but that Ritz-type cracker, I thought it worked really good because they're yummy and buttery, so. And then just something else really easy that you can do with smoked salmon that we have here is this is just cucumber slices, and it's got some cream cheese, some smoked salmon, and dill on it. And we didn't put a recipe up there for this because you don't really need one. You can use some flavored cream cheese if you wanted to, like the garlic herb one that they had, and just put that on. You can make your own herb cream cheese, so just mix some herbs in there and then put that on. Whether it's thyme or dill, whatever you prefer, and then you just top it with a little salmon. It's really easy. Actually, this would go nice with our sparkling wines, but I particularly like it with our Chardonnay. This is our two Avista Chardonnay, and it is lightly oak Chardonnay, and I think it holds up really well to the cucumbers. Cucumbers are a little conservative flavor and can stick with you. I just think that nice crispness that it has with a little bit of oak goes really well with the cucumber. So I think those were easy enough, right?
Okay, so you are going to learn very quickly that Aaron is much more adept in the kitchen than I am. I got the memo that this was easy snacks, and boy, do I have an easy one for you. So this is about as much as I can handle. I am going to make a one ingredient Zoom cocktail snack. Aaron, I'm very impressed with yours, but I can't handle it. This is so easy and it's so delicious. It's just sort of salty, crunchy goodness. And honestly, it's going to take you longer to preheat the oven than it is to actually put together the meal. So, you know, you're finishing up your workday, pop the oven on 400 and go back, finish up your last email. And then about 10, 15 minutes before it's time for your Zoom cocktail, all you need to do is grate about a half a cup of Parmesan cheese on a nice fine microplane. And you could even do this ahead of time and have it sitting in the fridge waiting for you. And all that you have to do at that point is take one heaping tablespoonful of Parmesan cheese, put it on a parchment paper lined sheet pan, and you want to kind of neaten up the circle into sort of a 2-inch ring. You'd think that these would spread, but they don't really. They kind of stay where they are, so make them look like what you want them to come out as. And leave maybe a half an inch between them, and then put them in the oven for 5 minutes, which is almost exactly the amount of time it takes to kind of get your wine glasses ready and get your wine ready to go. And once they come out of the oven, whoop, presto chango. They're just these beautiful little golden discs, and use your thinnest spatula to let them cool down for about a minute, and then use your thinnest spatula to get them off of the tray, and then you have these beautiful little crisps, which in my house disappear in about one glass worth of sparkling wine. So that was my super easy one. I really like that one with our Pommard. Is my favorite Pinot Noir, and that goes really well with these cheesy snacks, or the Ultra Brut is my other favorite. So I love both of those. So I have one other kind of looks fancy but is really easy cocktail snack. I call these my Netflix nuts, but they're bar nuts basically. And what I love about these is that they're really adaptable to whatever you happen to have in the house. As long as you have nuts, you need a fat, which can be melted butter or oil. You need an herb, which can be rosemary or thyme. You need a sweet, which can be maple syrup or brown sugar. And a spice, which can be cayenne, chipotle, chili powder, paprika. And you mix it all up and bake it. So let me show you how you do it. So I've got my 4 cups of unsalted nuts. This is important. Accidentally made this with salted nuts and it's not so good because it's way too salty. So you've got about 4 cups of nuts, and you want to put your tablespoon of melted butter. This is a good start.
Yeah, butter on nuts. That's an amazing idea.
2 tablespoons of maple syrup. So basically sort of your wet ingredients. And give that a good toss. And you can sort of pre-mix all of your dry ingredients together ahead of time. So this is 2 tablespoons of chopped rosemary, a teaspoon of sea salt, a 1/4 teaspoon of pepper, and a 1/2 teaspoon of cayenne. And you're just gonna, once you've got the nuts kind of evenly moist, then you can put in your, excuse my hands. It's not very cooking showy, but this is a fake cooking show, so deal with it. And give it a good mix. And lay it out on again, parchment paper lined sheet pan. And they'll come out of the oven a little bit sort of soft. You want to give them, you know, don't dive right in. They're really hot, and give them a few minutes to cool down, and then they'll sort of, the coating will also kind of harden up a little bit. So this is what you're going to end up with.
It's delicious.
I know. This is the problem with our segments is I want to eat and drink while we're actually doing.
Yeah. Before I try to trump Phoebe on ease of snacks, do we have any questions? Or?
I did have one question. What does the salmon cucumber pair best with?
So that one I would personally say our Chardonnay. This again is our Chula Vista Star Chardonnay, and it's lightly oaked. I personally really like lightly oaked Chardonnays. They don't overwhelm food too much. But they would go with any of our sparkling wines. I just like how the Chardonnay holds up to the cucumber a little bit more. So I'm trumping Phoebe on ease of snacks, which is, so fat and salt, one of their best friends together is sparkling wine, because sparkling wine is high in acidity, so it really holds up. And this is both of those things, salty and fatty. And all you have to do is open the bag. You don't have to pour them in a bowl. So you don't have no cleanup at that point. So we actually think this is a great snack. We do here caviar pairings, and we actually pair them with potato chips. So you could get that fancy, or you could also eat them right out of the bag. You could also do them with that smoked salmon dip, which would be really good. Yeah.
Here's another easy one.
Oh yeah, so this is popcorn, of course. Probably a lot of you have heard that popcorn goes really well with sparkling wine. I would say it goes with any of our sparkling wines. But we do have some actual pairings on our website. So if you go to our website and go to our blog and see, it's Chateau Style Movie Night, is it called? So there's some actual popcorn recipes and movie suggestions along with them, and which wine each popcorn goes with. There's one particular one that's delicious, that's Parmesan and peppercorn. It's really yummy. And they're so easy. You could pop your own popcorn, or you could get that microwave popcorn and just do a plain bag of it instead of buying the buttered one. You could pop that up and then just dress them up. So definitely check it out if you're looking for some fun popcorn ideas.
And a couple that I like, because it's clear that I don't like to work in the kitchen. We've got this, you might have seen on our website that we have these journeyman meat salumis. This is a local salumeria out of Sonoma, journeyman meat. And these salumis were specially developed to pair with our wines here at the winery. So it's what we serve here. And for now, while you can't come to the winery, we actually have these online. So this one is the saucisson sec, and this has actually some brut in it in the production. Pete makes it specially for us. So this, I love having salumi with my sparkling wine. It just is so easy and so delicious. And then also, clearly I'm a cheese fiend, so if you're like me, your cheese drawer can get kind of out of control sometimes with all these little bits and bobs that you kind of don't know what to do with. And I've discovered that there's this thing that you can do with all the leftover cheese bits. You can cut off the rinds and do mostly hard cheeses, but if you have some soft cheeses, that's fine. You can toss all that into a food processor, add some butter, some fresh parsley, some white wine, and some garlic, and whir it up, and there you have this delicious cheese spread from all your cheese leftovers. And I think we're going to link to, Alton Brown has a recipe for this that we'll link to. You can take a look. But that's one of my other favorite little, I'm in quarantine, I need a snack right now.
Sounds amazing. I'm going to go dig through my cheese drawer. Yes, I have a cheese drawer, don't judge.
Absolutely. Who is it?
I know. Yeah. Crazy.
I think we deserve a glass of wine.
Yeah, absolutely. And a snack.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I want to mention that Eileen Crane is going to be here next week, and she's going to be talking about Domaine Canaro. She's been here since the beginning, since before the building was here. So please join us next week. She'll have a lot of really great historical tidbits for you to hear. So it's going to be more of a story time with Eileen Crane. Yeah. So we're really excited about it.
Yep. Yeah. And all of the recipes, well, most of the recipes are on our blog if you want to check them out. And thank you so much for continuing to tune in to our Facebook Live sessions every Friday.